name is Vito Scaletta. I was born in Sicily in 1925. That little guy's me. I'm standing there with my parents and my sister Francesca in front of our old house. I don't really remember too much about the old country, except that we were pretty hard up. And then one day my father decided it was time to move away. Away from Sicily, across the ocean, to start a new life in America. Anything as fantastic as Empire Bay. It was beautiful. On the other hand, I'd never seen anything filthier, more disgusting than our new shithole of an apartment. The American dream. It was more like a nightmare. My father started working at the port for the guy who arranged our immigration. It was backbreaking work, and what little money he made mostly went towards booze. Eventually, my parents sent me to school. I had to learn English. I sure as hell wasn't gonna do that in a neighborhood full of Italians. That's where I met Joe.
Come on, Vito, hurry it up. We ain't got all night.
Over time, Joe and I got to be best friends. And since we were both poor and there wasn't much work around, shit, we started a little business of our own.
Freeze! Police! Stop!
Vito, this way! Throw me to bed! Stop! Hold the shoes!
Shit.
Okay, you bastard. Spread your legs.
Fuck.
And put your hands on the...
I'm sorry.
Well, that one time it didn't work out so good. The year was 1943. America was at war, and the army was looking for guys who spoke the language to help with the invasion of Sicily. I was 18, and anything seemed better than jail. Who says you can't go home again?
Operation Husky. I was assigned to the 504th Parachute Infantry. On the 11th of July, we were supposed to be dropped over the southern coast of Sicily, but we got hit by flak and had to bail out, way behind enemy lines. Only three of us made it. If it wasn't for the local resistance, we wouldn't have had a chance. So when Mussolini soldiers came into the town and started rounding everybody up, we decided to return the favor.
Se nessuno parla, quest'uomo morirà.
Eh? No, no, per favore, no. No, no.
All right, Scaletta, take the
allora,
shot.
Allora, traditori, pensavate di poterci prendere in giro? Di tradirci? Avete pensato male?
What the hell
vi facciamo vedere
for?
Noi
take
come trattiamo i
steps.
Traditori! Gli altri c'è nella resistenza! Rispondetemi, bastardi! O farò incendiare e radere al suolo questo paese di merda!
Senti, morti! Abbiamo preso il belga di scuola francese! Ma dove sei? Avanti, magari faccente!
They're falling back! Let's move!
On me!
Shit!
Gesù!
Aiuto! Senza fare prigioniere prima che arriva l'esercito!
GoPro! This guy's saying there's more troops headed this way.
You and Williams take out the machine guns, then find the prisoners. We're gonna need everybody we can.
Marco!
Piccolo!
Ain't getting through this way.
Warning! Looks like we found the machine gun. Watch it!
You got a grenade, Scaletta. This would be a great fucking time to use it.
Put a grenade through the window!
Scaletta, you alive?
Yeah, just about.
Well, then get off your ass and let's move it.
Whoa. Shit.
Grab all the ammo you can carry. This might be our last chance.
Must have the prisoners upstairs.
Clear the second floor. Scaletta, you take point.
Uccidete gli ostati!
Come on! Are we too much for you?
Got him.
The door, Scaletta. Kick it in.
Arrenditi, o gli faccio saltare il cervello.
Looks like we're going this way. Come on, then.
Oh, shit! How many
hands are you on?
He gives a fuck. Just keep shooting. What the hell are you doing?
Let's go.
Hey,
fine by me, asshole.
Shit! Stop it! It's gonna work!
You gotta keep moving.
Get inside! Get inside. Oh, you're gonna die out there!
Occupate, bastardo!
Get on that machine gun!
Lancia a bomb!
Mandiamoli. See the coming about this Scaletta? Get on it! Take out that truck!
Di stare attento.
Fregatene di fare attenzione, fai ciò che ti è stato detto!
Non sparate, pecciotti!
Che diavolo sta dicendo? Chi si crede di essere?
Un offerto da fare!
È davvero Don Carlo?
Cacetto, un congeco hanno samaritano in cucina.
Ma chi è quello? Lo conoscete?
Lo conoscono tutti. Don Calò è un uomo d'onore.
È uno stupido trucco degli americani, non ditemi che gli credete.
No, è davvero Don Calò. Ogni tanto dovesse ascoltare i consigli di noiazzi del posto. Ci rendiamo.
Sapete che potete fidarvi di me.
Don Carlo, the head of the Sicilian mob. An entire garrison of troops surrendered that day. Why? Because he told them to. Years later, the Nazis put a bullet in me. I was in the hospital for a bit. Then I got a month's leave so I could go home. At least for a little while.
Vito! Over here!
Joe!
Hey! Welcome home, buddy.
How'd you know?
I got my sources. Come on, let's take a ride.
Nice car.
Comes with the territory. I know you're itching to get home, but first, let's get a beer.
Yeah, sure.
There it is. Empire Bay. Tell the truth, you miss it?
Hey, there's a bear shit in the woods. Not like this place ever done me any favors, but... anything's better than a foxhole. What's with this shitty weather?
They're saying this is the coldest winter on record. Papers say it's gonna keep up like this for weeks. Don't worry, though. A drink will warm you right up. How long's it been since we had a drink together, Vito? 2 years?
Almost three. Tony Sicelli's party, right?
Come on, Vito. Come on. The last drink we had together was right after your romance funeral. Right before you shipped out. You remember.
5 minutes. We're already talking about my deadbeat father. Can we change the subject, please?
So tell me, pal, what was it like over there anyway? I kept reading the papers to see what was going on, and you know how much I hate reading.
Yeah, I know.
You guys kicked Mussolini's ass, right?
Sort of. We had a little help from a guy named Don Carlo.
No shit, Don Carlo. I heard of him.
Really?
You bet. I know guys like him over here, wise guys. You work for them, you're set. You fuck with them, you die.
Nice to see you've been busy.
Yeah, and I heard you got a medal, right?
From old man Patton himself.
Whoa, so you're a real war hero, huh? And then what? You screwed a couple of Sicilian broads and came home?
Yeah, right.
The old country. Over here, you can screw anything with a heartbeat. No one gives a shit. What a country. Here's to the US of A and to having you back home.
Salud.
Salud, chin down. How come you're back? They let you out early for good behavior?
I took a bullet a couple months back, spent some time in the hospital, and now I'm on leave.
Wait. You mean you gotta go back?
What'd you think? The war ain't over yet.
You don't want to go back, do you?
Of course not, but what can I do?
1 minute. Wait right here.
Both mother and daughter working for the Yankee dollar.
Hey, Giuseppe, it's Joe. Remember last week, you know... The guy's name is Vito Scaletta. Thanks, Giuseppe. All right, I'll see you later. Situation is mighty queer, like the Yankee girl, the okay, listen up. It appears that your injury is much more serious than it first appeared, and the doctors say you can't fight no more.
What? Oh, whoa. Did you just...
Like I said, I know people. You get all the official paperwork tomorrow. When it comes to the right stamps and signatures, it's just a question of money.
You're kidding me, right? Isn't that a bit risky? It's me that can end up in a slammer, you know? And how am I gonna pay for it?
I got it covered. Think of it as a welcome home present. And don't worry, the documents will be clean.
Trust me.
Well, thanks.
You're welcome. Come on, Friday, you're like a brother to me. Now you can start thinking about what you're gonna do next.
Sure. But first, I gotta go home.
All right, you want a ride?
No, thanks. I want to walk around a little, see what's changed since I've been gone.
No problem. Say hello to your sister for me. Come see me tomorrow. We got a lot to talk about.
I can't believe you just got me out of the service. Thanks again.
No problem.
I'll catch up with you tomorrow. Thanks. Keep the change.
The fire is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping.
Hey, what's the good word?
And I brought me.
How you doing, soldier?
Lot better now that I'm home.
You on leave or home for good?
That's classified. So, what's new around here?
Tell the truth, not much. Everybody just wants the war to be over. And they're saying this is the coldest winter on record. Wish I had some good news for you.
Yeah, you and me both. All right, I'll see you.
Catch you later, buddy.
And my dear, we're still goodbye. But as long as you'd love me so, let it snow and snow.
Vito! Is that you?
Hello, Mrs.
Vito? It is you! You look so handsome in that uniform. Your mother must be so proud. And what about poor Salvatore Montemaggiore? How's he doing? His poor mother was expecting him home a week ago.
Yeah, Sal joined the Navy. I'm in the Army. It's different.
Why don't you come inside and have some tea with me, Vito? You could tell me all about it.
Thanks, but I'm kind of in a hurry. I just got back, and I can't wait to see my mother and Frankie.
Such a pretty girl, that Francesca. It's a wonder she's not married yet. Well, say hello to your mother for me, Vito.
That way.
That
fuck
crazy
off,
brother's
you.
Really got Georgie brother balls, huh?
Hey, more beer for us, right? Let's go.
Attends Yalta Conference. Empire Bay's coldest winter since 1922. Extra, extra. I'm freezing my balls off out here. Extra. Empire Bay police chief.
I thought the little girls weren't allowed to fight in the army.
Something I can do for you, soldier?
Is that you?
Hey, Mr. Manara. You closing the shop?
Yeah, you know how it is. Can't afford to stay in business no more.
Wow, I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, the war's not your fault, Vito. Who knows? Maybe when the war ends, I'll open up again.
Well, good luck then.
Hey, thanks, kid.
Hi, Mama. I'm back.
Vito. Vito, my boy. My boy's home. I thought I'd never see you again. Francesca and me, we wait.
Hey, sis, what's going on?
We wait for you.
Yeah.
So sit down. You must be hungry, Vito. Francesca made you a special dinner. Zuppa di pollo. It's good for you.
Wow, looks good, Frankie.
It's a shame your papa didn't live to see this. He would be so proud, Vito.
Yeah, sure.
Vito, you know better.
Sorry, Mama, sorry.
Benedice, Signore, la manciata, che è la tua volontà. Siamo ricevendo, provvedere nel cuore vicino di noi.
You should get some sleep. Your room is just like you left it.
So how you two been? Franny, what you been up to?
I still live here with Mama. I got a nice office job. It pays the bills, and I started paying off some of Papa's debts.
Francesca, we don't want to talk about that now.
So, you got a boyfriend yet?
Not yet.
What's that? The boys in the neighborhood these days are not so good. She'll meet the right man one day. How are you, mio bandino? It must have been so terrible. I was so afraid. I prayed for you every day.
I'm okay, Ma. I drove a Jeep most of the time. Sometimes I had a fight. I'll see you 2 in the morning.
Sleep well, mio bambino.
This ain't gonna cut it. I gotta find a place to stay.
So you have to go back soon?
Actually, looks like I won't. Joe's taking care of it for me.
Joe, you want to get into trouble again?
Mama, would you rather me go back and get shot again?
No.
Exactly.
No.
Joe probably saved my life.
Promise that you won't get in any more trouble with that, Joe. You know, your papa used to work for this man at the waterfront named Papalardo. He's in the union. You could talk to him, work hard like you were your pop. Talk to him. Please, promise me you go talk to him today.
Okay, Mama, okay, I promise.
Grazie a Dio.
I don't give
I'm
a
sorry.
Damn. I don't care
we'll
if you gotta
money.
Sell everything
I
you got. What the hell's going on here?
Vito!
You mind your business,
no.
asshole.
Oh, yeah?
Come on, Junior. I'm gonna take you to school.
Oh, tough guy. Scaring a woman, huh? Come on, show me what you got.
Vito, please. You're making it even worse. Stop, please! Vito, what are you doing?
Yeah, that's right. Get the fuck out of here. You're gonna be sorry. The both of yous.
What the hell was that all about?
I'm sorry, Vito. We didn't want to bother you with this.
Bother me? Bother me with what? Come on, tell me what's going on here, Frankie.
Right before he died, Papa borrowed money. A lot of money from a loan shark. Thinking he'd get a better job and pay him back. We found out right after you left for the war.
How much?
$2,000.
What? Shit.
The worst thing is, this guy wants it all back by the end of this week. Otherwise, the debt goes up again.
I ain't gonna make that kind of money working at the port. Who is this guy?
I don't know. Mama won't tell me. It's okay, Vito. We'll manage somehow.
Don't worry. I'll take care of this. I promise.
Thanks, Vito. Take care of yourself.
I gotta get my hands on 2 grand fast. I bet Joe could help me out.
asked yet?
It's the same as when you asked me 10 seconds ago.
For crying out loud.
What the hell's the matter with you now?
It's taking you forever, and I'm cold.
Just sit in the damn car if you're cold.
It's cold in the car, too. Hurry up and fix this piece of junk.
It'd get done a hell of a lot quicker if you quit nagging me and give me a hand.
I am not nagging you.
Yeah, uh-huh. Well, if you were as good with a wrench as you were with your mount, we could have this damn thing fixed already.
You are so useless. It's no wonder the army wouldn't take you.
You had to bring that up again, didn't you?
Ethel's husband, Frank, he's a fighter pilot. Margaret's husband, Charlie, he drives a submarine.
I'm warning you.
My husband? Oh, he's a 4F. He works at the grocery store.
You know what? Fix it yourself, then, you lousy bitch!
Buzz off, mister.
Hey, need a hand?
Sure do. Hope you're better at this thing than my good-for-nothing husband.
There we go. All done. I just needed to, screw a couple things in.
Really? Well, thank you very much, handsome.
Don't mention it. Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives?
To the right of the stairs. And tell him that racket last night has to stop. If he don't like it, he can find another place to live.
You're not at all. Come on in, let's talk.
You disgusting pig.
I picked up these broads on my way back from the store. I've been waiting for you. All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business. Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. Why do you have to stop when we can all have fun?
The fun's over, baby. Later, I said. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. Now, you know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know, but I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money, and punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the 20 bucks the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers. Let's go.
Whoa, look at this bed.
Hey, I don't know how you did things in the army, but here it's only one man to a bed, all right?
What, are you kidding me? After seeing the two broads that just left, I wouldn't touch that thing if you paid me. This is where I'm gonna sleep.
Plenty of hot water.
Hey, Wayo, who's this skinny guy in the picture?
That was back in 41.
You haven't changed at all. You know, in the face.
Fuck you. The good life will do that to you.
You made enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to furnish the place.
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set, because you know me. Thought about what you're gonna do now?
You said you were gonna introduce me to that guy Giuseppe.
I meant, you know, the big picture. When you was over there, didn't you think about what you was gonna do when you got back?
No, not really. Well, besides the usual, you know. Find a nice girl, settle down.
Whoa. Hey, there's gonna be plenty of time for that shit later. Right now, I'm gonna make sure you live a little.
Hey, thanks again for that thing with the discharge papers.
Hey, all I do is make a phone call. You can thank Giuseppe when we go pick him up.
Hey, you think I could,
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, but this ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
It's, never mind. You're gonna let me drive a...
All right. Here's the keys. Just be fucking careful. All right, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over there on the right.
I know, Joe, I know.
Okay, now make a right here. Then just go straight for a while. Hey, Vito, you know what time it is?
It's daytime. How the fuck should I know?
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to if I could afford one.
Who says you're gonna pay for it? You know, you wasn't kidding. They really taught you to drive over there. At least something good come out of it. Ooh, get a load of that baby.
Nice, that's a 42 Jefferson.
Beautiful car like that, it'd be a shame to smash the window. You should grab yourself some lockpicks over at Giuseppe's. Welcome to Giuseppe's General Store, a thief's paradise. You name it, he's got it. He even sells phony gun permits and discharge papers for guys tired of getting their asses shot off. Hey, Giuseppe, I brought you a new customer.
He's straight up, right?
Yes, sir, all the way. This here's Vito, my oldest friend. This is Giuseppe, the best safecracker in Empire
retired,
Bay.
Retired, please. How are you? Papers for you?
Yeah, they are. You got them finished already?
It was a pain in the ass, but sure, they're done.
Well, thanks. This really gonna work?
Nobody from the army will bother you again, trust me.
You see? What'd I tell you? Here's the money. Take your papers, Vito.
We need a set of lockpicks, too.
That we do. And guess who's paying for them?
Grazie. Well, you can test it right now. Here, take this lock. You just need to insert the pick into the lock and lift all the pins. You use the wrench to hold the pins one by one. When all of the pins are set, just turn the wrench and the lock. Oh, damn it.
See you around, Giuseppe. Se benedig.
Easy, huh?
Don't worry. You'll get the hang of it. I do it all the time when I lock my keys in the car. Bonito. Okay, you still feel like snagging that car?
You kidding me? Absolutely.
Well, here's your chance.
Possible Grand Theft Auto.
Step on it.
10-4. Vehicle theft in progress. In pursuit of suspect.
Yeah, well, it's not over yet. Lose him, quick.
Roger that.
All right. Looks like we lost it. So how do you like the car?
Not too bad. Think I'll keep it.
All right, let's go find ourselves a body shop. They provide the kind of services we're looking for.
Hey, that don't sound cheap.
Don't worry about it. I got it covered. Just find any body shop. I know the guy who runs them. Park right here in front of the garage door. Okay, now honk your horn.
What's going on? What can I do you for, pal? New license plate. For you, no problem. There you go. Gave her a couple of tweaks. We can paint it any color you like. Take your pick. Are you looking for a new set of wheels? Take your pick, pal. Thanks a lot.
All right, next you should introduce yourself to Mike Bruski. He'll probably have some work for you.
All right, where is he?
He owns a junkyard over in Riverside. You can't miss it.
Hey, who's that guy back there?
What guy?
The guy at the body shop.
Oh, Tommy. He's my buddy's nephew. He's kind of quiet, but let me tell you, the kid's some hell of a dancer. Saw him at the old dance hall in Oyster Bay a couple of weeks ago. He had all the broads going nuts.
Do I detect a hint of jealousy?
Are you kidding? I don't need no dance moves. I got charm, my friend. Here, I'll give you some of my lines, so maybe you won't have to spend so many nights with Rosie Palm and her five sisters. Hey, here's one. Hey, is that a mirror in your pocket? Because I can see myself in your pants. Now, here, I got another one. If I could rearrange the alphabet, I'd put you and I together.
Oh, come on.
Oh, this one never fails. Hey, baby, that's a nice outfit. It'll look good crumpled up at the foot of my bed in the morning.
And this works for you.
Oh, here's a good one. Hey, do you know the difference between sex and conversation? No? You want to go back to my place and talk?
You got problems, you know that?
How about this one? Why don't we go back to my place and play house? You beat the door and I'll slam you.
Oh, that was bad.
Hey, when you measure seven soft, you don't have to be good with words. You get my drift? Hey, take it easy where the road curves up here. A couple of weeks ago, some guy went right through the damn guardrail and drowned it in the water. Okay, now make a right here. All right, almost there. Make a right up here. That's Mike's junkyard, there. Just drive through the gate.
Look who's here.
Hey, Mikey boy, what's going on? Shit, Mike, you can wash your fucking hands once in a while. Now I need a fucking bath.
Hey, I've been working. Working people occasionally get dirty, you know? Besides, I just wiped them off.
With what? The same fucking rag you used to clean the toilet, you filthy fuck?
Put a lid on it. What are you, from the health department, or you want to do some business?
Business, of course. This here's my friend Vito. Vito, this is Mike Bruski, but don't shake his hand. I ain't got that much soap at home.
Nice to meet you, Vito.
Me and Vito go way back. He just come back from overseas and he needs some cash. So I figure he can help with your, supply problem. I can vouch for him.
Uh-huh. Okay. Joe told you about our side business, right?
Yeah.
I only want regular cars, nothing fancy. You get a cut of every car. I take as many as I can handle. And don't bring no cops around, okay? They follow you here. I don't know your ass from Jesus. You get me?
Got it.
God damn it, Mike. You put your grubby mitts on my fucking coat. I paid a fortune for this thing.
All right, calm down or I'll stick them up your ass, you sissy.
You know, dry cleaning costs these days.
Jesus Christ.
And who knows if they can even get this filth out.
You shut up. Vito, listen to me. I need a Walter coupe today. I got a few people looking for parts, but I can't find a car.
Because you don't know where to look. Every time I drive down Hunters, I see one parked by a bar there. I think the place is called the Lone Star.
Isn't that a Moulinan neighborhood? I'll stick out like a sore thumb.
All right, look, I'll give you $350 for it. It's worth the risk, right?
$400.
All right, deal.
Vito, come on, let's go. Andiamo. Meantime, I'll be sending you the cleaning bill for my coat.
Yeah, I'll change my address, you rat prick.
Okay, listen up. This is your maiden voyage, so to speak. So try not to fuck it up, eh? Here, Vito, take this, just in case.
Hey, nice. Hey, Mike, you mind if I test this thing out here?
Sure. Knock yourself out. Here you go. Aim for that old wreck over there.
A bad shot. Hey, Vito, see if you can hit the gas tank.
Shit. Did I leave gas in that thing?
There's a Polak joke there, but I'll leave it alone.
Oh, yeah, that reminds me. Fuck you.
All right, that's enough shooting. We got work to do.